everyone, and a very warm welcome to WS CubeTech. So guys, in our previous session, we have covered that what are those websites that have infinite scroll. In our today's session, we are going to talk about how we can infinitely scroll any website with the help of Selenium. In this video, I'll be taking the help of a website called as Ajio India. It's an e-commerce website where we have different beauty products or clothes and accessories. Okay, so we will be infinitely scrolling this website. Now let's have a look on how it can be done. So first of all, I'll go to my browser and in here, I'll write Ajio India. I'll open this website in here. Let's wait for a while. Click on women and in women, we are going to, okay. It went to women only. So yeah, again, in the women's section, we'll go for footwear. And I hope it has clicked on footwear. Yes, we have reached footwear. But if you remember in our previous session, we have seen that it has around 36,000 products. Now, instead, what we'll do, we'll go for some categories. Maybe we can go for, as it's winters, we can go for boots. Where are boots? Can't find boots. Heels and flip-flop, casual shoes. And there are no boots. Why it's showing me handbags though? Let me just search it once again. I just want to go with something that has around hundreds of figure. So let's go for sneakers. Okay. I'll apply sneakers in here. Okay. So here we have sneakers and these are around 1116 items. Okay. Then still it will take a little while for it to load. So what we'll do over here is very simple that if I scroll down to the last product, it will load for me. And then it will show me more products, and then again if I'll scroll down again it will load and it will show me more products. So I want this to happen with the help of what? With the help of our Selenium. So to make this happen with the help of Selenium, first of all let's copy the link from the top. Okay, and let's go back to our page. I'll paste the link in here, and as soon as I'll run it, it will open a Chrome driver for me, and I hope this page opens in here. So yeah, this page opened. As you can see clearly over here, it's taking a little while to load because there are lots of products. So let's give it a time.sleep, maybe of 5 seconds. So I'll write in here time.sleep for 5 seconds so that our page gets enough time to load. Once we have given it enough time to load, let's find the height of the page. To find the height of the page, I'll write over here a variable called as height. Height is equals to driver.executeScript. And in here we'll write return, and that should be in our double quotation that I want it to return the document's height. So I'll write here document dot body dot, not actually it should be dot, and scroll capital H height. You have to write it in the exact same way, and then we'll print the height as well, that what is the height. And now as soon as I'll run it, let's wait for 5 seconds, and after 5 seconds, I hope we have received the height in here. So it's still waiting for 5 seconds and the height of the page is 8,970. Now what I wanted to do, I wanted to scroll up to this height. To make it scroll up to this height, I'll be writing driver.executeScript. Now I'll be writing window.scroll capital T2. And in here we can pass that it should start from 0, comma. We can write the exact same height over here, or what we can do, the better method is we can directly write this thing, that document.body.scrollHeight, which is giving us this same output. So we'll pass it in here, close the brackets, okay, and then we are ready. And let's see if it automatically scrolls for us or not. So again, I'll open it. It will take a while to load. We'll wait for 5 seconds, and after 5 seconds, it will automatically scroll for us and will take us to the bottom of the page. Yeah. So this is what here it is happening, right? It is automatically taking us to the bottom of the page. Now what I want it to repeat this same procedure again and again. So for that, I'll be writing while loop in here, and I'll tell it that every time you have to scroll, okay? And till what time you have to scroll? Till we have achieved the new height. So now we have a new height because once we have scrolled and new products have loaded, So again, we have got a new height over here. So let's create a variable called as new height, that our new height is equal to, again, we'll repeat this same, very same procedure, the driver.execute script. Okay. So I'll pass this in here. Once we have passed this in here, now it will give us a new height. But when it will break, when it will stop doing it, when this new height will be equal to whatever the height of the document is, that means when we have reached at the bottom of the page, then it will break. So we'll give a condition over here that if height is equal to new height, in that condition break. Okay, so now let's run and see what will happen. So it's taking forever to load this page. So many products are here and that's why it's taking a lot of time. I just hope that 5 seconds are enough and our code starts working. So 5 seconds are enough and our code has started working. And as you can see on the right hand side, this bar is automatically getting smaller and smaller. Why it is getting smaller and smaller? Because it is automatically loading more products for us, right? So it will keep doing it until we have reached the bottom. And now why I am making you do this is very simple, that if this code, this whatever code we have written right now, if we apply this on any website, let it be any website which has infinite scroll, then it will definitely work on that website. That means this code is constant for every website. All you need to do is you need to change the URL of the page. And as soon as you'll change the URL of the page, be able to do this procedure on the different websites as well. So there were around 1000 products, and as you can see, it's taking a little still while to load these products. So let's just wait for it. So finally, it has stopped scrolling now and we have reached at the end of this page. Okay. And the last height that we have obtained over here is 1,05,270. That is the last height that we have achieved in here. And these are all the heights that we have scrolled through. Okay. So this is how we can get the height, this is how we can scroll any website infinitely by using this one simple code. Now let me show you another example as well. Suppose if I'll open a new tab, and we have seen Nike India as well. So let's go in here, let's go on the web page, on the website. Let's search for anything. Let's go for maybe sale, or just let's go for the shoes. Okay. Let's copy the link from the top. I'll just copy this link, go back in here and paste this link in here. Okay, now if I run this, so I have not made any changes over here except for the link. Okay, so now as soon as I'll run it, again, it will open the website for me on the very same page. It will wait for 5 seconds. As for Ajio, we have given 4 to 5 seconds. So let it wait for 5 seconds, and it has only 128 products. So let's see how much we'll scroll. And after 5 seconds, it will start scrolling. So you can see we have reached at the bottom of the page. Again, it will scroll for us. Again, it is scrolling for us. And I think that this will stop pretty soon. Why? Because we only have 128 products. And yes, it has stopped for us. So we have reached at the bottom. Yeah. Okay, we got some pop-up over here. And we have got the height as well. That was 10,967. So guys, this is how this code works, that it is very common for all the websites. All you need to do is you need to just change the URL and it will work on any website that has infinite scroll. So I hope guys that you have no doubts in the question in what we have covered in our this session. In our next session, we'll learn that we have covered how to scrap data from Beautiful Soup. We have covered that how to infinitely scroll a website. We'll combine both of them and fetch the data from a website that has infinite scroll, and we'll scrap the data from there and put it in our Excel. So stay connected guys, and I'll see you in the next session. Thank you.